welcome, 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 welcome to Master G's Theater. And you know you are joined by your host, Master G, and the best co-host on the planet, CLB. Hello.
CLB in the house. Hello.
DJ Boom.
I am in the building.
Hello.
Greetings.
Ah, yes. And
say R-B.
Hey, and let's listen. Today's show is going to be a stone gas, baby.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Let me tell you, today, I can't think of multiple things.
Right.
I only have a one-track mind.
We're like zoned in.
You know what I'm saying? Yes. I only have a one-track mind.
It's like on fire.
And I kind of feel like if anybody...
Right.
You know, gives us a problem.
We're going to
beat them down like a punk.
It's going down.
You know what I'm saying?
Are you giving clues right now?
You see
now?
Where I'm going?
Yeah.
Because today's guest is 2022 Atlanta inductee, Diamond D.
Diamond D. Yes.
Yes, that's right. So, but after the break.
Yes. But so, shout out to everybody that listens. And shout out to those that are listening for the first time. This is our show. This is our thing. We are, you know, moving and grooving, putting positive energy in the universe, talking about hip hop, talking about life, talking about the pursuit of happiness. And we're doing it all because you're letting us get down to the funky sound.
And what are you guys talking about? We have one segment today because we have Diamond D and Grandmaster D.
Yes.
What's
right.
your health segment about today?
Talk to us, Master G.
So our health segment today is about reaching out to those folks that have inhibitions about getting started on their fitness journey.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Love
it. It's hard when you haven't been working out for a minute to get back to it. Okay. We want to talk to Diamond D and Grandmaster, the two Ds.
D, Diamond D.
True that.
We got lots of Ds on the show, but...
D, Mickey Ficky, D.
Oh, I like that. You went with Mickey Ficky. Okay.
But...
Until then,
yes.
The hands of God.
Bring it on.
The R.
B.
I.
I.
Take it away.
Let's do it.
The R, the B, the I, the I, the I.
Everybody's waiting for Diamond D to slip, but it won't happen cause I'm just too swift. I got props from here to Albuquerque. Eat your ass up like a piece of beef jerky. Yeah, now let me start to get deep. I sweep the creeps who try to beef and keef, but I don't sweat it cause I got fat vocals. You couldn't see me with a pair of bifocals. I got the soul of Nat King Cole. If I go gold, I won't front the road and go commercial. No, not me. Never will I worry. Feet are on the ground so I can't lose my edge. I did my homework, I didn't jump off a ledge. And now I'm here, and no one can stop me. I clock cheese cause my raps ain't sloppy. Who would have thought but I pulled it off? Just like a bandit and brothers can't stand it. How the hell Diamond D get a deal? My rhymes are dope and all my beats appeal.
To who?
To the vast majority. Yeah, I kicked the flavor, I had to get a waiver to go to college back in 88. But now I'm straight. See, I give comfort like a silly pot to pee. My sound's profound, you can't beat it. Even with a baseball bat.
Watch that.
Cause I got a bag of tricks like Felix the Cat. You heard the rumor, now you know it's true. So go and tell your buddy that I'm not a funny duddy. And if you think that I can't get busy, then you can step to me.
Word up.
Get up.
Diamond D, looking crazy.
just for kicks. I represent with the licks.
You want the cool ride, can't handle the crew. You want Lexus, Moonroof, Hennessy 80 crew. Scared to death, playing the game of life. So on ice.
Yeah, welcome back to Master G's Theater, and I'm your host, Master G, with the mad, the bad, the cool, and the calm, the collective, CB, CLB,
hello,
and DJ Boom.
I am still here.
And the RB, the I, and we got to keep this funk going.
We got to keep it going. It's exciting today. Atlanta inductee.
Yes.
2022. One of the greatest, if not the greatest, producer on the mic.
I have to agree.
We have the one and only on the line right now with us, Diamond D!
Diamond D.
Yo, what's up?
What's up, Diamond? How you doing, brother?
I'm good, man. How you doing?
Good to talk to you. Yet again, we keep ending up in the same spot. And I want to just thank you, man, for one, being who you are, and two, coming on the show and agreeing to do the show with us. So appreciate you, man.
Come on, man. You got to talk to the legends.
Bless your heart. Bless your heart.
Well, speaking of legends, okay, you know, congratulations, D, on your induction into the world's first hip-hop museum.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yeah, man, I really appreciate that, for real.
Well, you're incredibly deserving.
Totally.
And we always ask our legendary guests, but in this case our legendary inductees, if they can remember the very first hip-hop song they ever heard.
King Tim the Third.
Wow. Ooh. Now that's a good one right there.
King Tim the Third.
Arguably, it wasn't a hip-hop record, though. But,
no, right. It's disco. You know. Right.
No, it's R&B.
It's R&B.
Yeah. Fatback Band. Fatback Band. They were like a soul band at the time,
right?
And they were
yes.
And King Tim was like a radio jock, right? Or a DJ jock.
Yes, I believe so.
And he was the first one.
Personality.
He was the first person to be on a record rapping that was on a national level, you know, with that Fatback Band song. And then there was another group that came after that.
So where did DJ Hollywood's record come out, before or after King Tim?
Wow.
Good question, huh?
Good question. We're going to investigate that.
D, where did you hear the song?
On the radio as a kid.
Yeah.
I think King Tim, it came out maybe 2 months before Rapper's Delight.
Yeah.
It was a short period.
Yes, because it got blown away by
an executive director that sits to my left.
Yeah, I'm just, you know, being the executive director of the hip hop museum that you're being inducted into.
Right.
And also the front man for the legendary Sugarhill gang.
Of course.
I just, you know, merely speak facts. Kim Ting's record was great, but, you know, there was a record that did come out a little bit after that that kind of, you know, put the rockets on the socket. So.
And also, you know, the King Tim, he was more like a disco jock.
Right. Yeah, he wasn't rapping. He was just kind of like
saying a few rhymes. Now, the Sugarhill Gang, they hold claim to that.
Thank you.
Okay,
hey,
so.
Yo, G, I told you before, you had the best rhymes anyway. Everybody know it.
Thank you, Diamond.
I appreciate you saying that. No disrespect to Hank. And Wonder Mike.
I got you. I'm with you.
All know who wrote Hank's rhymes, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, that's a whole nother story.
Hey, D, you know, you grew up in the Bronx, 10456, if I'm not mistaken.
Right over there, no doubt.
10456. He loves to shout it out because, you know, that's where he grew up and where he's from. Can you please tell us about Forest Projects and what it was like, how you got into hip hop living in that area?
Well, aside from Cold Crush tapes, Flash tapes, the local DJs in my neighborhood were these two brothers named DJ Supreme and DJ Hutch. And, you know, they had the big speakers, the two turntables and the microphones, and they basically provided the soundtrack for Forest Projects around this time. Also from Forest Projects, you had Love Buck Starsky.
Shout out to
Love Buck.
He's from over there. And right across the street is where Melly Mel and Kid Creole grew up at. Oh, so it's a lot of history over there.
Wow.
And being that I grew up over there, it was nothing for me to go outside and see these future legends in the park doing what they do. This is around the time where Master G would tell you, you know, they had to steal electricity from the lamppost.
Right.
You
right.
know?
Right. Yep.
For
yes.
real.
Yes. Yes. Yes and yes. Yeah, no, man. We definitely have seen this thing, you know, turn into something outstandingly phenomenal, wouldn't you say? I mean, to go from, you know, the block around the corner, basement parties, you know, just a New York, New Jersey kind of New York metropolitan area thing to now we got people in, you know, Russia rapping, you know, ain't that, that's the crazy thing, you know?
It is. And, you know, with all creators and black and brown people who were rejected, as I was told, rejected from attending the discotheques that were located downtown.
Yep.
You know, and out of that frustration grew hip hop.
Yep. Yep. Absolutely. Absolutely. And you've done so much, man. I mean, you know, like I said, we've had the great, I've had the pleasure of, you know, talking to you before on the Sugarhill Gang podcast. So that, you know, for you to be on the show, man, there's so many, talk about some of the projects that you've done. Because there's, you know, there's a few people that don't really know how deep you really go with this music. Just touch on some of the stuff that you've done for the people that don't know.
Well, I co-founded the DITC crew, mm-hmm. which the Digging in the Crates crew, which consisted of myself, Showbiz and AG, Lord Finesse, Fat Joe,
mm-hmm.
O.C. I'm the one who put Fat Joe on in the game.
Mm-hmm.
I produced his first album. I produced about eight cuts of the 12.
Wow.
Grand Nubians.
There it is.
Hold on 1 second.
Okay. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. It becomes a part of, you know, how we live with this thing. You know what I mean? To hear somebody like that, that's getting down.
Why did you decide to become a producer instead of a rapper?
Well, because I was a DJ first. And we all know most producers would start off as DJs. You learn, it's like blending records. But instead of blending records, you're just stacking tracks.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why, for most producers, we all started off as DJs. Whether it's Timbaland, Just Blaze, Dr. Dre, that's the premise of it all.
Before you were making beats, did you DJ for any groups that we would be familiar with, or any MCs?
No. Well, I was a DJ in a group. Go to your car lot. I was a DJ in the group The Ultimate Force.
Uh-huh.
And yeah. we were signed to Jazzy J's record label, Strong City Records.
And then, so what?
That was my first thing. What, that's like 1989.
So then, what beat machine did you first purchase to start making beats?
Hold on.
This
okay.
Is,
my guess
call,
is.
Pardon me, fellas.
Yeah. No, it's okay. My guess is an MPC, but he's going to say SP1200.
Yeah, I think you might be right.
I think it's MPC.
You think so? Yeah.
What's your guess? What beat machine?
Let's ask RBI.
SP. I'm going to say SP.
You say SP?
Which one? I feel like that's what probably like what him and Show were using. Show
you say SP.
Yeah.
I say MPC.
Hmm.
I'm sorry, fellas.
So we're
trying to figure out what's the first beatbox that you used. First drum machine that you used.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I had an Elise's HR 16.
Oh, wow.
With an Akai 900 sampler.
Oh, we were all wrong.
Yeah, we were all wrong.
So does that mean you have like a million?
People think I started off on the 1200, but I didn't.
He talked about that in the rap song. I do remember you mentioning that. Yeah, it's true.
Yeah. No, that was my first machine, the Alessis and the Akai 950.
So does that mean that you have like a million little floppy disks sitting around from your first beats?
Not a million, but it's a lot. It's a lot.
The reason I say, because like, remember the sampling time was so short on the Akai. It kind of felt like you only had like 3 seconds per button. And I had one. So trust me when I say,
well, we already know that
to
you
make
had
a
one.
Dope beat yeah, on I, the I, Akai, it was very right. hard.
Well, now, I mean, you know, it wasn't super hard. You know, it's about as complicated as the 1200.
CLB, you have a question.
Well, you know, we must learn, too. So I'm learning about your respect, Diamond D, and congratulations. I'm learning about
Thank
your
you.
Legacy that you're creating here in music. What was the big break for you? What do you consider your turning point?
That's a good question.
Being signed by Jazzy J in 1989. At this time, you know, Jazzy J, he was the Bronx legend. You know, he kind of started Def Jam when he made that record with T La Rock called It's Yours.
Whoa.
You know, yeah. and he signed the Master of the Ceremony. They had a big song called Sexy that was real huge in the tri-state. So I would say around the time when Jay signed me is when I knew shit could really happen for me.
Well, you definitely took the ball and ran with it, that's for sure. There's no question about it.
Okay, so you're making beats, you're placing beats, but at some point you decide, hey, I think I'm pretty good at this rapping. Who inspired you most to pick up the mic?
Mm-hmm.
Lord Finesse and Grand Pooh by Maxwell.
Whoa.
I hate to say I'm not surprised.
You know, I was around Finesse producing his first album with Premier and Showbiz, the fucking technician. So I was locked in for that. And Grand Poobah, I was around Poobah because he was also signed to Strong City Records when he was a member of the group The Masters of Ceremonies, which is right before Grand Nubian. So I would say them two.
Wow.
That's well, you do it quite well, brother. Speaking from somebody who has a little bit of experience at rocking microphones.
Hey, I appreciate that.
But D, you influenced so many, and I feel like your legacy is half the amazing recordings you produced and created, but half the people you inspired afterwards and the people you produced for, you know, like Joe and many others.
Yes.
So like,
right.
So and to me, just so you know, real quickly, I'm a DITC stan. Like growing up in Brooklyn, New York, I'm just telling you right now, as a 46-year-old man,
okay.
DITC is the greatest hip-hop collective of all time.
Okay.
Yeah, there are a lot of them.
We got you get that out.
I just need to get that off my chest.
Let the people in radio land know.
So, D, why'd you do it? Why did you assemble? How did you assemble? Why did you assemble these guys?
Well, I mean, we were already helping each other. We were all from the same neighborhood. We were already helping each other, and you know we all lived in the same projects or in the surrounding area. Lord Finesse lived across the street. Fat Joe lived across the street. Showbiz lived two blocks over. You know, AG lived about 10 minutes away. So you know we were all in the same area trying to. Now you can't make a left here. You can't make a left here. No left. So we were all in the same area.
And whose idea was it, though, to form a collective?
Probably me and Showbiz. Mm. I would say me and Showbiz. Like I said, we were already working with each other. You know, when me Showbiz, and hold on, you not here? Yeah, I mean, you good
I think
here?
It's amazing that every single producer in DITC except for Premier.
Yeah.
Rapped. Am I right to think that... Oh, and Buckwild. That's right. Buckwild and Premier are the only producers in DITC that didn't rap.
Right. Yeah, Buckwild and OC. Correct.
So
And AG.
What benefit do you think that you got from creating one... What benefit did your career get by aligning with all these other amazing acts?
Well, me being a producer, I was able to branch outside of my clique and work with other like-minded artists. So I think that in itself was a big deal.
Amazing. Amazing. That's all I got to say about
it. Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. D, D, so, yeah. You know, we have a chock-filled show today with two amazing DJs with D in their name.
Yes.
We have Diamond D on the show, and we have Grandmaster D coming up right after you.
Yes.
Do you remember listening to Grandmaster D and Houdini?
Of course. Who you know, you can't be my age and not be influenced by Houdini.
Right.
You know, Freaks Come Out at Night.
Yeah.
Friends.
5 minutes.
Five minutes of funk.
There it is.
I bought all those records.
Man.
we all did. You know, I found it hard to put into words, because it's so big, what impact Houdini had on hip-hop.
Right.
Just a sentence or two, yes. Can you try to help us, like, encapsulate why Houdini was so important?
To me, Houdini, you know, of course, they're older than me, but they signified the grown and sexy of hip-hop.
Mm.
You know, to me, that's what they symbolized. You know, they were the sex symbols of the time. You know, definitely got the ladies involved. You know, they left the grimy shit to other artists. You know, but to me, they were like, you know, the R&B hip hop group of the time, if you will.
Yeah, yeah, I'll go with you on that. Yeah, they definitely put that. They definitely put that R&B kind of feel to the hip hop. That
right.
we were listening to and that we were moving to at
the time. Shouts out to Larry Smith.
Yes,
right.
Yes, big time.
Amazing.
Shout out.
Amazing.
Rest in peace.
Producer and musician. Okay, D, you know, we would talk to you for hours if we had the time, but
yes.
I want you to say, Rock the Bells is covering the entire induction ceremony, so you'll be telling the whole world, you know, lots of things about your sentiments, but tell us what you want to leave, what you want people to remember you most for in your hip-hop legacy.
Wow. I wanted them to remember me as somebody who did three things on a high level. Produce, rap, and DJ.
Yeah. Well, that
you know,
if
I feel like going on a tour doing MC gigs, I'll line up 20 dates and do that. If I want to go on a tour where I'm doing DJ dates with the little 45s, I'll go do that. If I don't want to do any of those things, just focus on producing, I'll do that. But I'm one of the few who I feel can do all three at a high level.
I agree.
And I also think that's contributed to your longevity.
I know that has contributed to your longevity.
D, we can't leave without you talking about Rear View.
Yeah.
Let's talk about it.
Go. Brand new album. Who's on it?
Your man Positive News from De La Soul. West Side Gun from Griselda.
Mm.
New artists. Two new artists, Ashton Martin and KP. And Stacey Epps.
Wow.
R&B singer. She's mad fly.
I know Stacey.
You know, one thing about me, that's why I call the album The Rear View. Always honor your past, respect your past. Your past is what makes you.
That's right.
But don't live in the past. Always move forward.
There you go.
And whatever you do, always move forward.
What do you think?
I call this album The Rear View.
That's a great name.
So what do you want people, like, what was your idea with the album? Like, what do you want people to get from the album?
I want them to get that I am, if not the best, one of the best producers who rap. And you know, that's why I crafted the beats I crafted, and I picked the beats that I picked. I produced 7 songs, and the other 6 were produced by my man Focus, who's Dr. Dre's right hand man. Mm. My man Knots Raw.
Knots is the man.
Yeah. Drug Beats, Brady Beats.
Ooh, Drug. Shout out and, Dorian. Yep.
Yeah. My man Lynn Funk.
Mm.
Yeah. So dope. Like I said, you know, that's what I wanted to convey with this album. I feel I nailed it.
Well, I have heard much of it. I don't know if is the whole album now available for streaming?
Yeah, where can we get it?
Yeah. It dropped on Friday. It's on all platforms.
Okay.
So anyone, go get it.
Go get it.
Will people be able to pick up some vinyl or tapes anywhere?
Yep, the vinyls and CDs are available at fatbeats.com.
Okay.
Dope.
All right, man.
Yep. Hey, Jay, did you hear the Fat Joe skit?
No.
Oh, man, the Fat Joe skit on the album?
Huh?
The Fat Joe skit on the album?
Yeah.
Maybe I did.
You gotta check.
Tell us about it.
Yes.
No. Hold on. Sit tight.
Uh-oh.
I just texted to you.
Okay.
Oh snap.
That's hilarious.
I love when people say I just texted it to you.
Right.
And now I'm forwarding it to my DJ.
And we just see that's the producer in you, right? You see that, right? Diamond.
Right.
You see how you did that? It was effortless. It just made a move. Ba 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 da boom. You know?
All right. So as soon as we get off the line here, we're gonna cue that up and we're gonna take Grandmaster D. But Diamond. Seriously, congratulations and thank you so much for being who you are.
Yes, man.
Hey, man, I appreciate it, man. I look forward to seeing you on Friday.
Okay.
We'll see you on Friday. Thanks
again for
being
with us.
All
right.
Take care.
Later.
Congrats.
Peace. All right.
I don't know what to say. He's just so great. He's so talented.
That's amazing.
You know, let's throw to our DJ and take a break.
RBI.
RBI, take
us back.
Away. And
take
when
us
we come
away,
back,
and we come back,
the Grandmaster
D.
Here we go.
Sipping on some Bacardi Limey. That diamond, prone and shining, cause I'm nice. I turn men to mice, walk around with the ice on my necklace. In the 7, driving reckless. Honey, you blew it if my CD ain't on your checklist. See, you should expect this to blow. See, it's the bro who gets the dough on the low, like this.
From the L, from the L.
Probably won't leave until the thing ends.
There's a rumor being spread about me and the crew, about something we did or supposed to do.
Oh my God, I think I'm having a rap attack.
Yeah, Master G's Theater. We are rocking and rolling and hip hopping and soul glowing. I saw.
I love it.
that's my Coming to America bit. Yeah,
soul glowing.
No, anyway. Yeah,
it's your soul glowing.
It's on and popping. I mean, we doing a daggone thing.
Well, you know what? Only because you know this is one of your contemporaries and
yes.
So on. Your
friend. I'm gonna
let you do this intro.
Yes, I'm so excited because this is somebody that I grew up with. This is somebody that I know quite well. We have toured together. We have experienced living all in that. It's just I could go on and on. He's one of the greatest, if not one of the greatest, DJs. Performers, we've been on stage together. I can't. Is he here? Is he here right now?
Grandmaster D, are you with us?
D. From the L, from the L. Grandmaster D, are you there? Oh my goodness.
Oh no, it's so close.
But let me just continue to talk about this guy. You know what I mean? Like, as far as like the people in that time, in that era, you know, the ladies loved him. You know, he had the green eyes, and then he had the skills to pay the bills. You know, is and I got it. He's got to be here now. Grandmaster D, you here?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yay!
You,
so you, we did. Woo!
Did you heard? You heard me? Did you hear me talking about you?
Oh man, what? How much I owe you?
Well, you already paid him off before the show. It's
Thank
okay.
you for the love, man.
What up, D?
Grandmaster D, thanks for being with us.
Yeah, we might be a little bit out of range. I'm in Costa Rica right now.
Oh, nice.
No
nice.
Need to brag.
Nice. Somebody's got a nice one there. Costa Rica. Yeah.
A lot of rain out here right now.
Okay.
Well, there's a rainforest there, from what I understand.
Last time I checked. Well...
Grandmaster D, yeah, like, let's talk to us. You are our 2022 Atlanta inductee. Please tell us a little bit about how it feels to be inducted into the world's first hip-hop museum.
It's a blessing, 100% blessing.
You deserve it.
We owe it all to God, making this possible, and, you know, following your dream and believing your dream and not giving up, and, you know, we toured the world, we spread love all around the world. And it's a blessing, man. And we owe a lot to you too, G, because, you know, y'all was the first break ground worldwide.
Appreciate
with Baptist
that.
Delight. And, you know, like they say, the torch carried on. And everybody represents and everybody adds on to the site. But the blessing is, man, to be honored and to be inducted, it's a blessing.
Well, we couldn't be more happy, man, to have you to be a part of our celebration and to be a part of our situation. And of course, you know, like I said earlier, bringing you on, man, you know, you and I, we've been, you know, around this world together. We've been on stage together. And, you know, you're a phenomenal guy. You're an extremely talented performer. So, you know, this is well deserved. You deserve it, man.
Yeah, thank you. I know I want to give a credit to Jalil. For, you know, putting the group together, and may Ecstasy rest in peace.
Rest
and
in peace.
He had one of the greatest voices in hip hop. And, you know, the three of us, like they said, born and raised the streets of Brooklyn. Three of us, and we all good looking. it's just a blessing, man. You know, for all these years that we've been in the game, and the record sounds like it came out yesterday. It's yep. just a blessing.
Well, tell us, Grandmaster D, we always ask, you know, legendary cats, you know, what the very first either song you ever heard or the first experience you ever had with hip-hop was.
My God. Back in high school in 1977, I was a freshman in high school called Junior Richmond, and Master Don, may he rest in peace, from the Deaf Committee was in my class. And him and a brother named Ski Jump, and it was Ray Vaughn and Johnny Wall. We all was in that school together. But the first one that I heard that made me lose my mind was the King Tim III, but it was the Crash Crew too. But and you know, in that era.
Yeah.
But you know, Rapper Delight went worldwide. But as far as locally, it was like the Crash Crew yep. and the Boogie Boys and yep. Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde.
Yep. Yeah.
Stuff like that.
Yeah.
So then what made you want to start DJing? And was DJing like the first hip hop thing you did?
Yeah, I was a rapper before I was a DJ.
No way.
And okay. And Master Saddam being in my class, when he talked me into DJing, and he took me to his house. He's a little guy, man, real short, but he can rock them turntables. And another one was my idol was Wizkid. That passed away. He made a song called Play That Beat.
Oh yeah.
There's another one that was my mentor, and that was it. When Master Don took me to his house every other day after school, we would go and practice.
Well, you did well. You did a great job.
How did you get turntables?
Oh man, can you believe this? At that time I became a messenger in the city. I brought one turntable, my mother brought the second turntable, and I got a mixer. And I took it from there.
And then you just started rocking with no reservation.
Yes.
Yeah, no, man. You listen. You've done so many shows and you've been so many places. Tell me, like, one or two memories that stick out in your career. Because I mean, you've got a career that spans, you know, decades.
Let's say Japan.
Wow. Yeah.
To go to Japan and knowing they know about hip hop and they were dressed up with the Adidas suits and the Kangol hat.
Mm-hmm.
And my fondest time was when I got on the turntables and Jam Master J was with Run DMC at the time. And so it was like everybody wanted to shine. So I had to told my translator, I want you to go to the store and get me a dozen chopsticks. He said, chopstick? I said, yeah. He got me a dozen, came back, I tied rubber bands to the end. And Ja Rule said, you scratch the record with his mouth, you scratch with a sneaker, now he's gonna use chopsticks. And I had the rubber bands on the end. I said, good time. And I threw chopsticks in the air.
See?
And the Japanese said, Grandmaster!
What?
See?
Wow.
See? I knew it.
I don't even know what to say to this story.
Because it's amazing.
That brought tears to my eyes.
That's what I'm talking about. And this is what I'm saying about hip hop and this whole thing, man. The magnitude of this situation, especially from that generation. You know, like our generation is pivotal. You know what I mean? Because, you know, we were the ambassadors and still are the ambassadors of this movement. You know, the first of our kind and a lot of, like, you know, the first to be in this country or the first person that somebody ever saw physically DJ. You know, how many times do you think the first time somebody ever physically saw somebody DJ, it was Grandmaster D?
I mean, that just also means the amount of generations that have come since Grandmaster D. And that, you know, Houdini really kind of put him front and center in a few different songs. So tell us about, like, how you met, you know, Jaleel and Ecstasy and how the group became formed.
Yes, I met Jaleel and X were working for Mr. Magic on WHBI. He was answering the phones for him. And I went up there, and that's when Sugarhill had that big show at the Armory.
Yes.
you know that show, right, G?
Yes, I do.
Yes. And I came up there to help Mr. Magic promote it. And I met him at the radio station the week before. Yes. And that's how I met Jalo at the radio station. We exchanged numbers looking for a DJ. And the next week, him and X came by my crib. And I gave him a little demonstration. And it went from there.
Yeah, well,
wow.
Yeah, that
rest is history.
Yeah, I mean, it was a match made in heaven, basically, because, man, you guys fit together like a glove. There's no question about it.
Yes,
Grandmaster D, what do you think is the most impactful, you know, thing that has happened to you in music? What affected you the most out of all the tours, all the songs, all the, you know, amazing times? Is there something that sticks out in your head as a really amazing moment?
Yes, the amazing moment still runs today. The love and respect you get when you're walking in the street. I can be on 34th Street. I could be in Memphis, Tennessee. I can be in Los Angeles, and people will come up to me and say, Grandmaster, I respect what you've done for hip-hop. Mm-hmm. That's the blessing I get every time, that people can still recognize you and make you feel good. Because at that time, we didn't make records to disrespect anybody or disrespect women. We just came out with music, and the lyrics were so great from Jalo, writing some of the best songs of all time.
True.
And you got to give credit to Larry Smith. Larry Smith was our Quincy Jones of rap when it comes to hip-hop with the music.
Very well put. Very well put. Yes. Yeah.
It's really true. You know, we asked Diamond D the same question, but we'll ask you in closing, what you want your legacy to be in hip-hop? What do you want to be most known for?
Great lyrics, great stage show. First hip-hop group with dancers, and all about respect. That's all. And just the love that we poured into it. And what we got out of it, it means so much to me. And it's a blessing. And, you know, like I said, I give all the glory to God. because I don't want to take no credit because I'm just riding his way where I'm going.
We appreciate you.
Yeah,
we,
thank you so much.
We want to congratulate you again for being inducted into the Hip Hop Museum because you definitely deserve it. And you know the deal, man.
Hey, G, can I say something real quick?
Yeah, sure, please do. Sure. This is our music director, DJ RBI, with a question.
Of course.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, yo, Grandmaster. When you see me, you'll recognize me. You know what I mean? We got a little bit of history, but yo, I just wanted to from one DJ to another, man. I gotta take my hat off to you. You have been, the few times that I've seen you rock, been one of the best that I've seen on the turntables, man. So we'll give you props. You know what I mean?
Thank you so much, man. I really appreciate that from another DJ.
So, D, like I said, man. Oh, CLB?
I am not a DJ. However, I'm a huge Houdini fan.
Oh, okay.
So I'm one of those people that would like to thank you for your contribution to hip hop, to the culture, to being formulative for my life. It's just an honor to sit here and hear your story. So congratulations from my heart to yours.
And thank you so much, and keep doing what you do.
Thank you.
Thank you, Grandmaster D. We will see you Friday.
All right, man.
Yeah, you safe travels. Friday. I fly in Thursday morning.
All right, brother.
One love. We'll see you then.
One love, man.
All right, God bless. Thank y'all for having me.
Okay, brother.
Thanks, Grandmaster D. All right. Well.
All right, D.
Dope.
That was amazing. We had Diamond
goosebumps.
D.
I'm a little taken back.
We do need a microphone to hear your voice.
I'm a little taken back. I was a little
Diamond
taken
D
back.
Diamond D and Grandmaster D on one show.
I was taken
show.
Back so far back that I went back.
That you literally.
Yeah, I literally.
Taken a back.
On that.
Right, yeah.
Words.
It's kind of like, wow. That was
amazing.
A lot.
Taking it backwards. Wow, this show just, I feel like we're spent. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know about
that's
you guys.
That's a lot of energy.
I feel like this was a lot.
No, I know.
A lot
of
great conversations, man. That's the thing. Like, his brothers, he had a lot of knowledge, and they was very, very giving with the information. So, you know, we get enthralled. So, you know, blame it on the love, man. Blame
it
on the vibe.
What it is, too, is this thing is so organic, and I tell people this all the time, you know, which is one of the reasons why I'm having such a great time doing this show. That, you know, this music continues to just keep, you know, delving into the fiber of the world, you know, and it puts out so much energy, but it also requires so much energy, you know what I mean?
I also think that hip hop is moving into a new chapter.
Oh, definitely.
Okay, can we agree with that?
Oh, definitely.
And
I
think that us as the purveyors, especially yourself,
because
we're a little bit older,
we've
decided to take classic hip-hop into kind of like a preservation education right level, right?
Yes.
And we've almost kind of like...
Institutionalization.
Yeah, that's it's true.
Yeah.
That's a perfect way to put it.
Yes.
And we've almost like left the new stuff, like 2000 to like now, like to them, whoever them is.
Yes, let them deal with that. Let them deal with it. Not taking anything away from them.
It's like not even hip hop. It's a different thing, and it's cool. It is what it is.
It is what it is. But the fact that we have to really perpetuate the motion of this that we're doing right now is why this is so impactful.
Well, you know what? We have a few minutes left, so in order to perpetuate that, we have to be working out and we have to be healthy. So
we're going to do
absolutely.
Can you just like go right into some of your?
So the thing is this. You know, and I know how people feel, and believe me, I know how people feel. You know, there's a thing that happens when you get to a certain point where you get out of the swing of things, and you no longer, you know, you get to life and having families and business and so forth and so on. And you say, I'm gonna work out. Well, what I want to do at this point is I want to be the person that helps encourage the world and all the folks that's out there. The longest journey starts with the first step, okay? And what you wanna do, folks, is you just wanna just do something. It doesn't have to be, you know, getting a membership to a gym. You could just go for a walk, you know? If you went for a walk for 20 minutes, let's say you did that, you started out that way. Then you segue, you just say, you know, into going into a gym and you got on a treadmill. Let's say you don't want to go to a gym. There's, you know, flex machines and all these other different opportunities, the bike and all these. There's so many different things that you can do to get your fitness thing on. But you have to, you got to do it. Get c- come out of the bag. Don't feel intimidated. Do what you need to do to get out what you need to get out. Because I'm telling you, and I'm speaking from experience, and this is one of my passions in life as much as performing, doing this show. Fitness is the elixir vitae of life. People want to know how I'm able to do a radio show and fly to California and, you know, go on stage for an hour and a half and, you know, come back and do the museum. And people are like, we don't know how. I'm telling you guys, the fitness routine is my common denominator for everything. It helps in, you know, how I look, how I sound, endurance, aging. The aging process is a completely different process with a consistent workout situation. And I mean, it could be, again, walking, it could be Pilates, it could be yoga, it could be martial arts, it could be kickboxing, whatever. But it's 3 to 4 times a week of some sort of motion, anywhere from 20 minutes or more. And I promise you, and I mean this, and I don't generally say I can guarantee things because you're really not supposed, but I will guarantee if you can get some sort of movement situation happening 20 minutes, 3 to 4 times a week, and you do it over a period of time, you will feel better first, and you will see how much you look better in the latter. But you gotta just go ahead and, you know, it's, I hate to use the corny Nike thing, but you gotta do it. Just do it. Mm-hmm. You agree?
I'm with you, Master G. You have said it all. My only contribution is baby steps. Just right. Like you said, start small, because it can feel overwhelming. But Once you start and you start feeling good, it makes you say, okay, I'm going to do it again. And yes. I'm going to do it again. You keep going back for more. That's what happened with me when I resumed my regimen in my 30s.
Yes.
And so when it becomes a habit, honey, you're operating on a whole different level.
If you do something for 30 days, it will definitely become a habit. And then the other thing that I really want people to understand is to not gauge what you're doing based on what somebody else is doing.
Oh, yeah.
Do it at your own pace. Look at it, your own results. Base your own results on you and not your girlfriend or your buddy or, you know. And then the other thing I don't want to put into that equation, too, is the person that's 40 and 50 years old, don't try to do what a person 20 and 15 years old is doing. You know,
you wish you could, though.
Right.
No, of course, yes. Yeah, hey, listen, of course. But you don't want to, you know, a 20-year-old kid can walk in the gym, sit underneath a flat bench, put on a bunch of plates, and pound out 10 reps. A 50-year-old guy can't do that. Not coming out the box.
Tell me about it.
You know what I mean? It's not something you want to stretch. You want to get some cables and loosen up. You want to get your blood flowing. You want to get on the treadmill and warm up. You want to understand that your body is different from that 20-year-old's body, but you can get the same satisfaction as a 20-year-old if you're doing what it takes for your 50-year-old situation to progress.
Heard. And you know what I'll say? I'll say too, even though we're not in competition with each other, he's on a roll, guys.
I know he is. I'm not interrupting.
Even though we're not in competition with each other, it is good to have what I like to call accountability partners.
Yes. Yes.
People that you can rally with and say, okay, did you walk today? I sure did. Did you do so and so today?
Yes.
So having that commitment to another person or a group of people, whether it's a trainer, a friend, It does wonders for keeping you in the game.
Without question. That's the other part that I was going to bring into the equation too. Yes, it is great to find somebody in like manner, but always understand that if it's going to be, it's up to me.
Come on now.
Okay? You got to maintain your own level of movement. Walk to your own beat. Now, it helps if you get somebody else. But every time, everybody's not always going to see the picture the way that you see it.
So true.
So, yes, look for somebody to get down with, or look for somebody that you can, you know, bounce off of and get some motivation. But always remember that the best motivation is self-motivation.
Absolutely. And next episode, we're going to talk about how we get there.
That's
with
right.
That motivation.
Yes. So, with that being said, it's been an amazing situation. It's been an amazing show. We've had so much going on. CLB, of course, has been breathtakingly phenomenal. And
thank
DJ
you.
Boom has been the explosion that he always is.
Wow, wow. As long as you don't call me Ponytail.
No.
I chopped it all off. Hey, folks, can I just say something real quickly? Because yes, I think we actually have a little bit of time. So I want to tell you guys that I wasn't working out for like a few years because I had kids. You know what I mean? Life gets in the way, you know? Yeah. And I knew, actually, the guilt of something bad happening to me and leaving my children is what got me working out.
There you go.
And I just wanted to share, personally, what worked for me because I couldn't get to the gym right away. It wasn't even... All I did was, after I did the kid stuff, I put on some shorts and a t-shirt, and I just jogged about a mile. I got up to 2 miles, 3 miles.
There you go.
And then once I started feeling like, okay, I got my body moving,
right,
then I signed up for the gym.
There you go.
So I kind of say that because I don't know if other people are like me. You don't have to go do the whole like
gusto.
That's
what I'm saying, yes.
Right.
You can also just like go for a walk.
Exactly.
Yeah, folks trying to bust out and be Rocky.
Right. Right. Don't try to be Rocky.
That's the reason why that's the reason why I really wanted to, you know, talk about this, because people feel like, well, you know, I got to join a gym and get workout clothes and, you know, now I got to, you know, free weights. No, don't. That's the extreme, you know.
You can start with calisthenics.
Yeah, you can do push-ups in your house, man.
That's going to be challenging if you ain't done it in a while.
Trust
anyway.
Me, you can do sit-ups and push-ups, and in 10 minutes you'll be passed out, you know, when you first start. And then eventually it'll be, you know.
And let's not forget about activity points. I'm always for the activity points.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the extracurricular activities.
Oh yeah. Well,
that's movement too,
oh, that's
honey.
That's always movement. That's talking about exercise.
It's a good form of exercise.
It's a great form
scientifically
of exercise.
Proven.
It burns calories.
So, and on that note.
We're gonna say see you later.
See you later.
Yeah. Aww. So listen.
See you later.
Yeah. Look out for us on all the social media platforms. You're gonna find me at Master G Sugarhill. CLB, where can everybody find you?
I am CLB.online and for the museum at National Hip Hop Museum.
I am at DJ_LV.
DJ_RBI.
Yes. And always, folks, I will see you out there on the road in all various places from Maine to Spain. And I literally mean that. This is Master G's Theater. I am your host, Master G. I'm joined by CLB, DJ Boom, and the RBI. We thank you. Peace, y'all. And we are
out of here.
But in the meantime, the in-between time, if you work your thing, then I work mine. We came here together so we could have fun. Me and you, baby, going one-on-one. Now this is the last chance for us to get off. So either get loose or you ought to get lost. Cause I'm just about ready to do my thing. Cause I'm a stone cold New York rap machine. I'ma give you what I got, and baby, that's plenty. And never has one man rocked so many. I'ma make you wet and make you sweat. Just to see how funky you can get. Now when I'm on the mic, I do serve well, and I go by the name of the rapper Jalil. Now sit back, relax, put on your headgear. You're ready for a trip through the atmosphere. Gonna take you for a ride through the twilight zone. I don't need a spaceship, I use my microphone. So hold on tight with all your might, cause I'll be rocking like this for the rest of the night. It's Jalil, y'all, your master rapper. And when I'm on the mic, it's a sheer disaster. Cause MCs crumble when we rumble. Some think I'm soft just because I'm humble. So all you MCs, I hope you're real good listeners. Cause in this battle, I'm taking no prisoners. I'm slaying MCs right on the spot. Cause I'm the master of the rap, the doctor of the rock. The jack of all trades, the master of one. And the thing I master's called having fun. We got 3 minutes left to rock this funk. To separate the good stuff from
from the jump. So get in the groove and feel the sound. And once you're inside, spread yourself around. From the bottom to the top, top to the bottom. Come on, Mac, we can get funky while we got it. Start. We used to get together at the dark. Sometimes we rap, sometimes we sing. In the summer or the winter, cause it ain't no thing. And ever since I first came round, side by side, we would throw down. We came here to this here place to serve you all right to your face. Because this jam here is our showstopper. We didn't want to keep it, but I guess we got it. With the man of the hour, make the ladies scream and holler. Too hot to drop, too sweet to be sour. I'm gonna set the record straight, and I hope that it is not too late. I won't settle for less. Put your money on me, I'm your best bet. Come on, one for the trouble, two for the bass, three for the ladies, four for the play, 5 minutes of funk. This ain't no dump. So pull your bottom off the tree stump. Ladies real pretty, city to city. But now we're getting down to the nitty gritty. From the bottom to the top, top to the bottom. I'm gonna rock them while I still got them. I'll rap and shower, has style and power. And this disco hour. I don't know it, all of you have heard. So it's up to me to spread the word about the man that we feel. It's got to be real. I'm proud prince on the wheels of steel. He goes by the name of Grandmaster D. So if it's alright with you, it's alright with me. We're gonna rock you people's minds with ease, with some help from the maestro, if you please.
Thank you.